The decision of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, to deploy troops to Niger should not be seen as the regional body moving against a country or as a decision of an individual member nation. President of the ECOWAS Commission, Omar Aliyu Touré, says it should rather be seen as a resolve of West African leaders to uphold agreements all members countries have signed to it. Kende Amodu reports.
By directing its Committee of Chiefs of Defense Staff to activate its standby force and deploy to Niger, ECOWAS has not declared war on its member state. The president of the ECOWAS Commission explains that the option of peace remains very much on the table.
ECOWAS has been engaged in peaceful and diplomatic efforts to effect the restoration of constitutional order in Niger, and the communique has made it very clear the authority has kept that window open.
But it seems the consensus among West African leaders is that the military junta in Niger should be eased out.
We will not accept coup d'etats,
and I think these putschists must go. If I don't let Bazoum out to be able to exercise his mandate, I think we should move ahead and get them out. Bazoum is a democratically elected president. He should be freed. He should be able to exercise his mandate freely.
The ECOWAS decision is also not being driven by a single country, but is a collective agenda of leaders of the regional bloc.
So this is a regional initiative. It's not an individual country going after another country or a community going after or the community going against citizens of the community. Nigerians are ECOWAS citizens, and I think it is important we all recall that before the attempted coup, nobody imposed sanctions on Niger.
I want to insist, this is not a Nigerian affair. It's an affair of ECOWAS. ECOWAS is nearly 400 million people, 240 million in Nigeria, 140 million in the West African Monetary Union. So this is 400 million people. If we don't have democracy, do you think that our countries will be able to move ahead? This coup d'etat is not acceptable. We should put an end to it.
The outcome of the extraordinary summit in Abuja has sent reverberations across the region. All eyes are on ECOWAS to see if it will follow the path of diplomacy and peace, or if, at the last resort, it will be forced to rule out the thanks. From the federal capital, Kehinde Amodu, Trust TV News.